So yes, by that we have finished cough drugs and the treatment. So I have some questions with me so that we'll solve together because you will understand like what till what extent you have understood my lesson. And before that I'll like briefly give you the introduction of this drugs, that is antitussives. Antitussives, they are cough suppressants. Like in a one word statement, we are dealing the MOA or we are giving the all definition of antitussives. Antitussives cough suppressant, and it will inhibit the tussle impulses. Okay, now coming to expectorants. Expectorants, it will either increase or decrease sorry sorry expectorants will increase or decrease the mucal secretions, right? Next, coming to mucolytic means lysis, that means it will alter the viscosity, I told you. Next, mucokinetics is moving, it will help in movement of the mucus, that is it will make the mucus to watery. H2O is water. Okay, now we'll go with our first question. I have 20 to 21 questions. We'll deal with that. I'll go speed. Okay. Now first question. Okay, we'll go start with our first question. We'll see. A young patient is diagnosed with asthma. Okay, the patient has asthma. His primary symptom was frequent cough. Okay. Now it is not bronchospasm and wheezing. Asthma medication started, but until their effect develop, we want to suppress the cough without running the risk of suppressing ventilatory drive or causing sedation, which is the best drug. Okay, now the patient is asthmatic patient, the symptom is a cough, and he has no bronchospasm and wheezing. So coming to codeine, it is not used in asthmatic patients. So yes, we will ultimately eliminate this first answer. Now coming to second one, dextromethorphan. Yes, here he told that to give the temporary relief, okay, temporary effect. So I told you dextromethorphan, it is NMDA receptor blocker, and it will it is non opioid derivative, non addicting NMDA receptor blocker, and it will give a temporary relief. Okay, we can use this class of drug. Promethazine here, it is not the drug, because it promethazine, I told you the MOA is it will relieve the bronchospasm. Here he told that it is not a bronchospasm and wheezing, so ultimately we will eliminate this, and none of this is not the answer. So dextromethorphan, the answer would be B for this. Okay, now coming to second one, which of the following statements regarding the opiate action is correct? Now opiates means antitussives, what they do, they block the they increase the threshold at the cough center, as well as they block the tussle impulses, right? Trigger the vagal reflex of the to suppress the cough, no. Cause diarrhea, no. Stimulate the production of the cough, no. Suppress the cough center, yes. The answer is D for this. Okay, now coming to next, which is not a mucolytic. Now mucolytic, lytic is I told we have two bromhexins and two cysteines, one Dornase alpha, okay, one Vasaka. Here bromhexin, yes, it is a mucolytic. Acylcysteine is a mucolytic. Potassium iodide is not, because it is mucokinetic. So answer is D. Now coming to anticholinergics are administered. So here one thing I want to say, coming to respiratory diseases, respiratory tract diseases, we need the treatment to start its pharmacological effect within a short period of time, because if we take IV, it will take time, orally it will take lot of time, rectally it is a not appropriate place because we are treating the respiratory. So inhalation is the best method to treat this. So next one, the highest concentration of the cough receptors, they are highly present in larynx, that is a direct answer. Now what are antitussives? I told you they are cough suppressants. They'll suppress the cough at cough center in the brain, and also they'll decrease the impulses of the tussle. So here we can say cough stimulants, no. They will reduce the cough. Cough suppressants, yes. Increase secretions, no. The answer would be B. Okay, Now coming to what treatments are used to reduce the stimuli at the that act on the receptors. Okay, here I would like to explain something, because what treatments are used to reduce the stimuli that act on receptors. Here antitussives. Okay, I'll draw a image here. This is our lung tracheal, and this is our brain, and these are the impulses. This is a lung, this is a brain, these are the impulses going in and out. Here the treatments are used to reduce the stimuli. Okay, antitussives, they act and they'll come here, means after they'll block the impulses, but they will not reduce the impulses. So here linctus, these are the pharyngeal demulcents, they'll form a protective coating here, so they will inhibit, they'll not cause the impulses to generate. There is no way of generating of impulses, so the ultimate answer is B here. Now coming to varus cuff center, this is a direct answer, medulla, there's no discussion of that. We'll go to the second one, treatment of protective cuff mucolytics. Lytics, I told, it is a chemical, it will alter the chemical characteristics of the mucus, so it will decrease the viscosity of mucus and increase the volume of the mucus. You can say the answer is it will decrease the viscosity of the mucus, right? Now expectorants, protective cuff treatment, expectorants, I told you, it will either increase or decrease the secretions of the mucus. That is, answer would be B, increase the volume of the secretions. Now coming to what medication is used below the larynx to reduce stimuli, that is afferent side, and suppress the cough. Here I can tell you, opioids, that is antitussives, no, because it will block the efferent stimuli. So this is cuff center, this is afferent, this is efferent, and this is these are our lungs. So these opioids, antitussive, will block this efferent. So here he is asking about afferent, so no. Sedatives, we are not using sedatives here. And coming to linctus, they'll form a protective coat, there is no generation of the impulses, so ultimately the nebulized anesthetic would be the answer for this. Now coming to 11th one, one of the uses given below for the opioids is not correct. Opioids, it is used as antitussive, it is correct. Analgesic, yes, it is used as analgesic. Anti-inflammatory, no. Anti-diarrheal, yes. So the answer is C for this. Now coming to next one, following is not a piece, sorry, it is a pharmacological, it is not a pharmacological effect of the morphine. Okay, actions of morphine, constriction of pupil, yes. CNS depressant, yes, it is a CNS depressant. Diarrhea, no, because it is anti-diarrheal. And respiratory depression, yes, so the answer would be C here. Instead, it causes constipation. On long use of morphine, it causes constipation, so yes, the answer would be C, my dear buddies. Okay, now coming to the next one, expectorants that act both airway and reflexly. See, here the answer is potassium iodide, no. Terfenadine, it is not a anti, like we are not using that in a, what you say, cuff. And bromhexine, it is depolymerization, is a MOA. So ultimately guaifenesin, I told you, we have the, I gave the like MOA by giving such arrows at the last of the page, you can remember that. Okay, now coming, okay guys, now the next one is bromhexane acts, so that is MOA of the bromhexane. Now I already told you that bromhexane, it acts by depolymerization. Okay, inhibiting cuff center, no. Irritating gastric mucosa and reflexly increasing bronchial, no. Depolymerization, yes, this is the right answer, but we'll go to the next option. Desensitizing stretch receptors, no. Desensitizing stretch receptor is a what drug, I can say, that array, it's that. Okay, we'll go to the next one, I'm not remembering that. Okay, the next one is codeine is clinically used as analgesic, yes. Antitussive, yes. Antidiarrheal, yes. So all of the above is the answer. And next one is mucokinetic is a drug. Okay, the action of mucokinetic reduces airway mucus secretion, no. It increases the airway mucus secretion. No, it makes respiratory secretions more watery. Yes, this is the answer. It stimulates. No, so we'll go. The answer is a C. So yes, guys, before that 14th question, we had a D option, that which one which acts by inhibiting the pulmonary stretch receptors. It is both central plus periphery acting. We have one drug, no, benzonatate. It is that benzonatate for that. Okay, now antitussives act by antitussive. I told that it will block the cuff receptor, that is, it will increase the threshold at the cuff receptor and it will block the tussal impulses. Okay, now liquefying bronchial secretions, no. Rising the threshold at cuff center, yes. Reducing the cuff impulses coming from the lungs, yes. So the answer would be both B plus C, that is D. Now coming to dextromethorphan, is dextromethorphan is ultimately antitussive. It is not an no. It is antitussive. It is a direct question. Okay. Now, which of the following is not an antitussive? Antitussive, we have this in non-oxaliodine, in non-addicting, non-opioid. These both are non-addicting, non-opioid. This is non-addicting opioid. And dextromethorphan, dextro. See, dextromethorphan is an antitussive. This is dextropropoxyphene. It is not an antitussive. So answer would be C. Now coming to last second question. The following antitussive is present in opium but has no analgesic and addicting properties. I stressfully told you in explaining the MOA, that is, nascopine is the only drug which has less no analgesic and less antitussive action. Okay. The answer would be nascopin. Okay, now the last but not the least question of this session, that is, following is not neither specific antitussive nor expectorant nor bronchodilator but commonly present in proprietary cough formulations, that is, ambroxol. It is a for mucokinetic, it is a non-opioid antitussive. This is a mucolytic. Sorry, this is mucolytic, this is mucokinetic, and this one, chlorpheniramine, would be the appropriate answer for this. So by this, I have completed the cuff explanation of this session. Actually, I had a request from one of my subscribers, Sunil Cairo or Kauro something. Sorry for misspelling your name. Sorry for that. But so finally, I'm here by completing this session of cuff. So, and here's, just don't forget to subscribe, like, and share my video. And if you want any classes, then you can comment down below in the comment section, so that further I'll be like giving explanations for you. So thank you for subscribing, and thank you so much. If you have any doubts and queries, then don't be shy to feel the questions in the comment section below. And this is Sneha signing off. Bye bye.